Erev Tov, Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live here, still in Duluth, Georgia. The conference has ended, and I'll be doing some work here this week trying to share with you some of the information that we have been able to hear at the conference there. We will be uploading the debate between Dr. Pidgeon and author Zin Garcia. I'm sure that'll be a very interesting insights for all of you to be able to hear as well. My wife, Yana Benoon, incredible presentation on the dangers of vaccines as well as transhumanism. No doubt that'll be a blessing in Laurel Austin. Her own private experiences there that she has had, her own family has suffered from the injuries of vaccines there. We'll be loading these up here on Israeli News Live later this week. It's going to be quite intensive on the editing of this because I'll have to be working with individual PowerPoints that'll need to be uploaded as well in these. So please just be a little bit patient with us there. I wanted to take the time to share with you some interesting news that is going on here. Very troubling situation. It definitely looks like that we are on the verge of a war with North Korea. I want you to hear what Murad Gazdiev here has to say here from RT. And I actually communicate through messaging with Murad Gazdiev quite from time to time. I don't want to say quite often, but from time to time we do text one another back and forth. And he's really been a blessing for us in sharing some insights on what's going on in Syria as well as Ukraine. But I want to share with you now what he says about the U.S. preparing for war with North Korea. Listen to what the statements are here.
Do you have any doubts that the United States is preparing for war? Look at what's happening on the ground. U.S. troops, jets, various forces are arriving to South Korea in an endless stream. Anti-air missile systems are blanketing the airspace, and there are endless war games, simulations, exercises all around North Korea carried out by the United States, its allies, and South Korea. This isn't about scaring North Korea. That can't be done. This is about putting all the pieces into place so that when the final go order comes, everybody's ready. After all, Donald Trump promised to deal with North Korea. Didn't say how.
We'll handle North Korea. We're going to be able to handle them. It will be handled.
Very troubling information indeed from what we're seeing there from Murad Gazdiev with RT News there. Reporter there. And not only that, there is some other interesting things that are coming out that could be playing in on this. Let me just share some of the things with you here. This here article here from, let me go to the Tactical Investor, says America's woes, worthless dollars forces USA to engage Russia. I want to come back to that article in just a second there, because actually what I wanted to share with you before that is this latest video coming out. This is shared on Already Happened with our good friend Lorenzo there in Italy, sharing with us a video there of a large contingent of military equipment headed for Los Angeles. Now, according to Lorenzo with Already Happened here, this huge train carrying tanks and all types of military equipment there are headed to Los Angeles. Now, Lorenzo believes that this equipment is actually going to be loaded on a ship and taken for a battle against North Korea. Whether or not that's the case or not, I don't know. I know there is some very serious concerns that we may be facing an attack on our southern border with ISIS coming across the border there. So these tanks may be being positioned for a possibility of this type of scenario. Not really sure how that's going to play out. Also, Foreign Minister Lavrov of Russia saying to Rex Tillerson the exact response Russia is taking based on the latest U.S. sanctions that have been placed on Russia there. They have downsized the number of U.S. diplomats as far as U.S. personnel working at embassies inside of Russia from 755 to 455. But he goes into great detail with Rex Tillerson how Russia is going to respond to the latest sanctions there. And he calls them unfriendly. And also, Foreign Minister Lavrov calls those sanctions something that is dangerous for international security. Very troubling words there. Don't forget that Russia has also vowed to protect North Korea, much like China has, in the event that they would be willing to work with Russia on their nuclear program. So how much cooperation would it take for Russia to help protect North Korea from an attack by the United States? That still remains to be seen. Now, backing up to the other article here that I just spoke to you about before from Tactical Investor here, America's woes, worthless dollars forces USA to engage Russia. Very troubling article here. Says here, one of the reasons that the US has engaged Russia, that it has made it a mission to wean itself from the dollar. This does not sit well with the U.S. for many other nations could follow Russia's footsteps, as it is a dominant and powerful player in the energy sector. More importantly, Russia is the only nation capable of taking on the U.S. and not afraid of doing so. Putin has stated many times that he wanted to price Russian resources in multiple currencies and avoid the dollar. His contention is that the U.S. creates money out of thin air and is doing so, is defrauding the entire world, and his point is valid. The article goes on to state that when Saddam Hussein started selling oil in euros, the U.S. attacked Iraq shortly after that. And when Libya started to state it wanted to move to selling oil in euros, Gaddafi was taken out. Goes into some other issues there as well. And this is maybe perhaps, I guess the article is trying to imply here, why the pressure has been put on Russia the way it has. And clearly, as we have seen ourselves, the sanctions against Russia clearly are unwarranted. Russia has not been guilty of the things that they have been accused of by the United States. So it kind of stands to reason that this may be the main reason why Russia is being targeted by the U.S. Shy of a military intervention. We'll have to see how that plays out. Anyway, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Kind of a quick take of our broadcast there. As soon as we get back into South Florida there, we will get back in the sea here, get you more caught up on things that are going on, and also share with you some powerful insights that came out of this conference. I'll be also sharing with you personally some incredible revelation, actually kind of inspired by my wife's report on transhumanism, as she compared that with the temple of God and an invasion of the temple of God, us being our bodies being the temple of God. Just some incredible insight that the Lord dealt with me on this issue here. I'll share that with you as well. No doubt, altogether will be a true blessing to you. I'm Stephen Benoon with Israeli News Live. Erev Tov.